Imagine you're butt ass naked, barbecue sauce all on your titties, and your mom walks in. What are you gonna say?
Yeah, so clearly I don't know how to start this, but it's me, Big Dick Lil Balls, you know, with a story time. And I was around 14 at the time, you know, just getting settled into those long, sad, and lonely porn-filled nights. But on one of those nights, I was at a party with a friend of mine at the time, who I'll call Mike for now. So Mike is the kind of guy who drinks a lot, even though he knows he shouldn't. And by the end of the party, I was basically babysitting this bitch. Fucked up thing was is that he invited me out, so it's like, fuck my good time, right? Fuck me. After about an hour of Mike talking to girls about their dildo collections, I realized Mike had drank way too fucking much and that we needed to leave. So, you know, the guy I am, I go up to Mike and I tell him, like, we should leave. And he's like, alright, we go to the door, and then I turn around and Mike's not behind me. So now I'm feeling like I'm stuck in a fucking Where's Waldo book looking for this drunk bastard. So I'm walking around asking everyone, like, have you seen Mike? Oh, no Mike? No, Mike's not there. Oh, so I go fucking walk around, and I eventually find him at the beer pong table taking shots of tequila. So I grab this motherfucker by the ear like I'm Run's mother from Chicken Little. I drag him outside, and eventually I start to convince him that we need to go home because he's too fucked up. And as we started walking away from the party and towards Mike's house, it started downpouring harder than a priest staring at two altar boys. And we still had 4 or 5 miles to walk to Mike's house, and he is way too fucked up to be walking out in the rain like this. At the time, we were by this college that had construction going on, and we were freaking out, so we didn't know where the fuck to go. So we saw this unfinished building, and around the building there was a fence, and I mean, I hopped the fence with ease, but Mike must have watched Humpty Dumpty one too many times because he was scared of what was at the bottom. So the next 20 minutes were spent trying to get this wallow-shaped fuckwad down just for him to pass out and faceplant into a fucking puddle. And after he finally fucking wakes up, he starts to complain about his Jordan 1s that were so fucking fresh being ruined because of me. Like, I don't see how the fuck that's my problem, but cool, whatever fucking floats your boat, Mike. So as I'm here trying to find a way inside, he's throwing a fit about his clothes, and after about another 20 minutes doing that, I finally see some scaffolding on the side that leads to an open window on the next floor. So anyways, I started climbing, and right as I get inside, I hear a male voice yell something, and I thought it was Mike, but then I heard 3 very distinct voices yelling. So I start walking across this sketchy floor to look out a window to find Mike running away, and a man with a flashlight behind him. And then I hear the door from downstairs open and shut very quietly, and I made a quick 180 to see a flashlight being shined up from the stairway. So like any other kid under the influence would do, I started running towards the open window, and I looked back to see if I was being chased, only to trip on the fucking windowsill a couple seconds later and go flying into a belly flop onto the other side of the fence. I quickly recovered from that though, and I continued to run for at least a mile, eventually running into Mike and his older brother, only to get brought home to jerk off in peace, you know? But yeah, that's my story. Trespassing. Moral of the story? I don't know. Don't be a Mike. Like, imagine slowly growing over the course of 9 months just to be named Mike. Like, what are you, fucking gay?